Hello, my name is Anushka Janju and I just want to tell you that your channel is just amazing. Your explanations are superb, interesting, and with your videos I don't have any doubts left in my mind. Your videos are just fun way to learn. Thank you so much and keep posting your videos.
So children, let's begin today's video with mesophytes. Now, in my previous video, I had already told you children what are hydrophytes and what are the different adaptations that are found in hydrophytes. So today we are going to see and study about mesophytes and the adaptations that are found in them. Now, mesophytes are the terrestrial plants that can survive in neither too hot nor too wet conditions. That means neither they need a lot of water, neither they need absolutely dry conditions. They need a moderate amount of water. The mesophytes have well adapted body structure and the functions to suit the water requirement according to the availability. That means children, the body is adapted in such a way that they can survive very well in a situation where they get only the moderate amount of water. Now, what are the adaptations that are seen children? The mesophytic habitat or the mesic habitat is a terrestrial habitat, having good amount of moisture in the soil and high humidity in the atmosphere. Now these mesophytes children are kind of terrestrial plants. Terrestrial were the land plants that are found on the land. Now for survival, they need high humidity in the air. They need a lot of moisture in the air as well as they need moisture in the soil. That means water should be present in the soil from where the roots can absorb it. The soil in which they grow is neither very wet nor very dry. The soil contains sufficient aeration. Aeration means children, the amount of the air that is present in the soil. And if now you must be wondering why the plant needs the air in the soil. So the plants need the air in the soil children because inside the soil the roots of the plant are found. And roots also do respiration. That means they also do breathing. They take in the air and they give out the air. So in case in the soil air is not present children, then the roots will start dying. Temperature is moderate. These habitats are ideal terrestrial habitats for the growth of irrigated crop fields and the tropical forest. Now these are the things that are required for a good mesophyte to grow. That means they should get proper amount of water and air. Mesophyte plants have the following characteristics. Leaves are broad but thin. Broad means they should be quite in the leaves. Should be broad enough. This is known as the broadness of the leaves, children. This. So they should be broad, but if you look from the side, children, they should be thin. Stomata are in abundance. You have a lot of stomata present on the upper and the lower surface of the leaf. Now remember what was stomata, children? Stomata are the small openings that are found on the surface of the leaf, which helps in the exchange of gases as well as in throwing out the excess amount of water that is absorbed by the roots. That was transpiration. The epidermis of the leaf is covered with a thin cuticle. The epidermis is the uppermost part of the leaf, the uppermost layer of the cells children that make up the leaf, that is known as epidermis. So it has a thin cuticle. Mechanical tissues and the conducting tissues are well developed. Now these two tissues are the two different tissues that are found in the leaves children. They are also well developed. Now exactly if you see children, the conducting tissue is not only present in the leaves but it is also present in the entire length of the plant. So they are well developed. Both the tissues are well developed. Root, stem and foliage. The set of leaves is known as children foliage. Shows the optimum development. The roots and the stem and the leaves are all well developed. Examples of mesophytes are many plants that you see all around your house or maybe in your garden or in the school garden, in the parks. They are all the examples of mesophytes like rose, sunflower, gulmohar, mustard, tomato, potato, etc. These are all mesophytes. Coming to the next one children, that is xerophytes. Now the plants that face scarcity of water, that means the plants that are found in places where there is less amount of water and the temperature is generally high. Those kinds of plants are known as xerophytes. And such xerophytic plants, the examples of this is the calotropis, acacia, opuntia, etc. These plants show various adaptations to conserve water. Now these plants, because they are found in the habitat children where there is less amount of water and the temperature is too high, so they have the various adaptations in the plant body where they can conserve, they can say save a lot of water. And whenever they get water, they are able to absorb the maximum water which is the soil has at that particular time, and then they keep on saving that water in the plant body itself. Now for them, for this condition, they have certain adaptations, which are: first, they have a very extensive and well developed root system. Now they have a very good root system that goes deep inside the soil in search of water. Leaves are reduced to spines or scales. Now leaves, as you can see over here children, these are actually the leaves of the plant. So the leaves of the plant are reduced into the spines, and that is so that they can save the water. Now you know children, right now I read that stomata are found on the surface of the leaf. So in case these stomata will be present on the leaf and they will have a proper leaf, then due to the stomatas being present, a lot of water will be lost from them. So to avoid this wastage of the water, in order to avoid the throwing out of the extra water, those stomatas are only not there. How? Because the leaves themselves are reduced into spines. Leaves are shed under the stressed ecological conditions to prevent the water loss. At times, even if they have leaves, and the leaves fall down so that the water is not being lost. Both leaf and stem surfaces have thick cuticle covering. Now both of them have a thick cuticle covering so that they can avoid the loss of water. Now on the surface of this stem and leaves, children, hair are present, or the waxy coating is present, so that again the water loss can be avoided. The stomata are less in number and are of the sunken types. The lesser number of stomatas are there, and that too they are sunken deep inside the leaves, so that again the water could be saved. The stem is spongy and helps to store water. Even the stem of such plants are spongy and it helps to store a maximum amount of water. Leaf surfaces are generally shiny and glazed so that they can reflect the light back and the heat, and so the plant is not being heated, and when the plant is not being heated, it will not be wasting any kind of water in order to maintain the body temperature. So this way children, a lot of adaptations are found in the xerophytes also, so that the plant is able to survive very well in such kind of conditions. And xerophytes are generally found in the desert areas where they get very less amount of water and the temperature is too high. So these adaptations will be seen in such kind of plants. Now here is a diagram given in your book children to show the cuticle covering over the upper epidermis and the lower one. See how they are present. So the cuticle is present over here also on the lower side as well as on the upper side. The sunken stomatas are there. Over here the stomatal cavity is there where the sunken stomatas are there, so that they can reduce the loss of water by transpiration. Now the last thing we do is, we see this is a picture of a cactus children. And next I'm going to tell you what are the different adaptations that are seen in a cactus. How the cactus are able to survive very well in the deserts. So the first point says its leaves are modified into spines or scales. As I had shown you the picture right now children, and you can see some of the pictures still, that the leaves are modified into the spines. This helps in reducing the loss of water from the leaf surface by the process of transpiration. Now what is transpiration children? Transpiration is a process by which leaves throw out the extra water that is absorbed by the plants. Because if it will not throw out the excess water children, the plant will start decaying. The stem and the leaf surface have a thick cuticle or a covering of a waxy substance. Right now in the picture I had shown you how they have the thick cuticle which helps to provide a waxy coating, or it provides a condition where the plant can save a lot of water. They have the sunken stomatas. The stem is mostly spongy or succulent. That means it is spongy. Why? Because it can store a lot of water. The fleshy leaf-like stem is called the phylloclade. Now look in this picture, children. This green color, big structures that you can see. Actually, these are not the leaves. Leaves are the spines. And this is actually the stem of the plant, which takes the shape of a green swollen structure. And even it performs a photosynthesis. This green swollen structure performs a photosynthesis. It is known as the phylloclade. The seeds remain dormant during the unfavorable period. That means they remain in a stage where they do not become active under the unfavorable conditions. They will only germinate when the conditions will turn favorable, when they will get all the conditions that are required for them to grow. Then only they become active. Otherwise, they remain in the dormant state. So dormant is the the passive state of the seed. So with this, we come to an end of today's video, children. Thank you. Bye-bye. So that's it for today's video, children. I hope I made myself very clear to you and you have understood each and every point that I have explained to you in today's video. If you have really understood, you know what is to be done. Please do like, share, comment, and don't forget to subscribe. And please hit the bell icon, because after that you will be notified with every new video that I'm going to upload. See you very soon with rest of the videos upcoming soon. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.